molten lava exploding out of the earth from deep beneath its surface at 1200 degrees centigrade. That's more than 2000 degrees Fahrenheit. Rivers of liquid rock that burn pathways of destruction as they give birth to new land. A process happening right now in places like Hawaii Island. Of course, flowing lava may be about the last thing on your mind when surrounded by Lake Superior's cold, clear waters and evergreen forests. But this greatest of the world's freshwater lakes features a remarkable lava legacy from the far, far distant past. All along Superior's Minnesota North Shore, evidence of the region's volcanic history surrounds you. The rock, found along rugged shorelines, on the faces of magnificent cliffs and plunging waterfalls, was forged by volcanoes. Through repeated eruptions over millions of years, they spouted massive quantities of lava. In some places, the accumulated layers are 12 miles thick. And this happened so long ago, it's difficult for us to imagine how much time has passed. Geologist Jim Miller has been studying Lake Superior's lava legacy for much of his career.
Once you learn the language of rocks, they tell unbelievable stories. And in this case of fountaining lavas coming out, you know, on a landscape that had no life on it, no life forms at all. It was barren, smoking, red hot lavas spilling out over the land surface. If you learn the language of the rocks, you can start reading the chapters of the Book of the Earth. And it's an incredible story.
The chapter about Lake Superior's lava legacy takes us back 1 billion years, almost a quarter of the Earth's history, to a time when life was limited to single cell organisms in the oceans. The planet spun so fast that each day lasted only 18 hours, and the atmosphere held so little oxygen that it would have been unbreathable. So much time has passed since then that the planet's constantly shifting tectonic plates, segments of the Earth's crust large enough to carry continents, have come together to form supercontinents and then drifted apart 3 times, moving at an average pace of 1 or 2 each year. Lake Superior's volcanoes were active when the North American landmass was near the equator, part of a supercontinent called Rodinia. Magma from the Earth's mantle, some 160 kilometers or 100 miles below the surface, rose through a mid-continental rift in the Earth's crust that began splitting the North American plate in two. The rift was much like the mid-Atlantic rift visible today in volcanically active Iceland. Due to that rift, Iceland is expanding, becoming wider. As North and South America continue to move away from Europe and Africa, and the Atlantic Ocean has filled the gap. But 1 billion years ago, North America's mid-continental rift took a different course.
It's what we call a failed rift. In this case, it didn't make an ocean basin. As a consequence, Wisconsin is still here with us. It should have been another continent that drifted away, but it didn't. The beauty of this is now in the Lake Superior region, we have all the rocks that go into defining what happens when continents break apart. We can't study that really in the Atlantic because it's mostly underwater. Here it's preserved in the rocks surrounding the Lake Superior Basin.
With Jim Miller as our guide, we'll take a close look at Sugarloaf Point, where the volcanic forces that shaped Lake Superior's North Shore have left behind some great stories.